it was Beatlemania. Some guy shows up at your house who calls himself Jesus.
Yeah.
And instead of calling the police, you invite him into the studio.
Yeah.
Don't you think that's crazy?
It didn't seem crazy at the time. The thing is, you know, what would happen is people would show up at my house.
At your door.
At the door.
No security.
And it wasn't those days.
Right.
Those days,
it's hard
you
to
didn't
imagine.
Think like that, you know?
Yeah.
And I would just be, if I had something going on, I would say, sorry, he's not in or whatever, you know. But in this case, I didn't. And I just went out to the door and said, yeah, what do you want? And he's sort of just a kind of bearded guy. And he said, I'm Jesus.
Hmm.
I said, you better come in.
Really?
You want a cup of tea? I thought, you know, so I just started chatting to him. And I thought, you know, he's probably not Jesus. He's probably just schizophrenic. A hippie, maybe schizophrenic. But I thought, you never know.
Right.
And I'm not going to say, go away, Jesus.
That's so true.
So I called him in and then I said, well, look, you know, I've got this session.
Yeah.
And if you want, you can come and hang out there. So I came into the guys and sort of said, look, he says he's Jesus. Now, I don't know if he is or isn't.
Right.
But I'm not going to take any chances here. Is it okay if he just sits in the corner?
And I said
to him, shh, don't say a word. Just be Jesus. And my memories from that period are quite hippie. It's quite sort of Glastonbury, man. You know, beards and stuff. And I remember the story of a guy coming to see me when I was up in Scotland, and he was the self-styled Queen of Norman. There's a little town in America, because I went by it on Route 66 a couple of years ago when I did my trip there. And he was great. He was just, you know, he said, I'm the Queen of Norman. Well, I said, well, you better come in then, you know, Your Majesty.